Good Sunday evening to everyone. I hope that you're having or have had a wonderful weekend. I want to first say thank you for listening. And for those of you who are new subscribers, welcome. God bless you. This is just going to be a casual discussion. I think about a week ago or maybe 2 weeks ago, I did like a Monday morning chat. This is going to be my Sunday edition of my Monday morning chat. I don't know if that's going to be a regular thing. It's just something that I feel inspired to do right now. In fact, I am in my house cooking right now and making some fish and butter beans. I guess you said, what kind of unprofessional teacher, Bible teacher is this that tells us what she's cooking? That's me. This is not a professional channel, if you haven't noticed yet. I'm not here as a professional preacher. I'm just a fellow servant of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And whenever the Lord gives me something to share with you all, I just share it, okay? I'm first partaker of whatever word he delivers through me to you. All right. But I wanted to come on because of inspiration. And I say inspiration, several things have inspired me to say this, but I believe all is rooted in the Holy Spirit, not any wrong motives. I always ask the Lord to search my heart and search my motives to make sure they're pure. If they're not, then you don't receive it. You know, that's my prayer. I will be honest and upfront to you. No manipulation, no ulterior motives. And so I want to say that some of you may not like what I'm about to share, so you may want to click off now. But those of you who would like to listen, by all means, listen. All right. I want to talk to you about being careful how you hear. Or maybe I'll just change this message. I don't know, to voices, whatever the name I settle on when I finally get through the vid. But I just want to talk to you about voices and the issue of, as Christians, you know, should we listen to everything and should we listen to everyone, even though they may be a Christian, even though they may be born again, you know, even though they may be living in a way that is acceptable to us. We don't know what any of us or our lives are like to God. We can only go by what we believe to be an upright life, but only God knows. But do we, or is it good for us to listen to everything or to learn from everyone or to allow everyone to teach us? And I've had this issue to come up recently as today in a comment. And let me just say, I never throw off what you guys call throw something. I don't know what the new hip term is, but when I was growing up, it was calling throwing off, you know, on anyone. I'm just here to share whatever the Lord shares with me, and without fear, without, you know, thought of, okay, I'm going to fall out with someone. No, I don't want to fall out with anyone. I just want to be a vessel that God can use, and whatever He inspires me to say, I'm going to say it. Amen. And I would hope that you would do the same thing and we would all say it in love. But the issue of do we listen to everyone? Do we receive from everyone just because they are a Christian? And I would say no. And I base that not only on my personal opinion, but I base that on the Word of God. Because our hearts, when we listen to someone, we're not just listening with our natural ears. We're listening with our spiritual ears. And whatever we intake through our spiritual ears is entering into our hearts. So the scripture tells us in Proverbs 4:23 that we should keep our heart or guard our hearts with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. So I personally believe that guarding of our heart includes guarding what we look at, guarding what we listen to, guarding the things that we do, guarding the things that we meditate on with our heart, because those things will spring up like a well of water out of us, and not only to us, but it will, especially those of us who share the gospel, we can defile many, the scripture says, if we're bitter. So we have to make sure that there's no root of bitterness in us, because those things can spread out to others. But in Luke chapter 8:18, It says, take heed therefore how you hear, for whosoever hath, to him shall be given, and whosoever hath not, from him shall be taken even that which he seemeth to have. That's Luke 8:18. But another translation of that same scripture in Matthew chapter 4, verse 24, it says, and he said unto them, take heed what you hear, with what measure you meet, it shall be measured to you, and unto you that hear shall more be given. Now, I can teach this, and it can, you know, I can go on a whole different subject with this, okay? But I want to key in on take heed of what ye hear. Take heed of what you hear. It's very important not only to pay attention to how we hear, but to pay attention to what we hear. Because see, you can be listening to something and not listening to it properly, listening to it through the ears, the carnal ears, or you can listen to it through spiritual ears. So not only should we be concerned about what we hear, but how we hear things. So whenever you are relating with someone, we should always pray that we would have spiritual ears. Something may sound good, something may sound appropriate, but we want to make sure that we are using the ears of the Holy Spirit. And that's going to filter whatever we hear. It's going to, and if you are a person of the Word, you're going to be one who already has the Word of God in you. So when you hear something, you're going to get a check within your spirit. I always say you'll get a check within your spirit. Now, that doesn't mean that sometimes something that's said, something may be said and we don't understand it, so we automatically reject it. No, it just means that we don't have understanding. And I believe that when we become mature in the things of God, we learn to discern when it's something that we just don't understand from something that's not the truth. There's a difference between the two. So you can't just say, okay, well, I'm feeling something here or I'm sensing something. I don't understand that, so it must not be true. No, it may just be a matter of you not having that understanding yet. And the Holy Spirit wants to show you more, wants to teach you more. Okay, so we must always maintain an ear to hear. But does that mean I listen to everyone? No, it does not. Because someone can be speaking truth, but within that truth, they can include some leaven. And when I say leaven, does leaven mean that they're always going to, you know, that means something wrong or something in error? So if they say something in error, then that means they're teaching leaven? No. Leaven means something bad, something malicious, something damaging. I can teach something and not present that 100% correct. But what is my motive behind the teaching? And what else is including in the teaching? Am I trying to teach it in a way as to spread something maliciously or with evil intentions? Or am I trying to teach it, but yet I am myself in error on a certain part of what I'm teaching? It's possible. I'm sure I have done it. I guess some of you are saying, yes, you sure have. Yes, I may have, and I'm humble enough to admit that maybe I have, and I'll allow the Holy Spirit to come back and show me those things. And I always pray that He does, and I pray that you would do the same thing too. So what I want to share with you is that as a Christian, you do not have to feel obligated to listen to every teacher just because they are a teacher. You don't have an obligation to listen and receive from every minister just because they are a minister. I think we make it hard on ourselves because we don't study the Word for ourselves. We don't meditate on the Word for ourselves. And we don't ask the Holy Spirit and invite the Holy Spirit in to minister to us. Amen? That brings me to the next discussion of prayer. Okay, prayer when dealing with other Christians, prayer when dealing with understanding the Word. Now, this video, you may say, what is she talking about? We're looking for one subject. You're going to have to hear it in the ears of the Spirit. All right, but I'm telling you about voices. You need to know how to handle the many voices that are in the world. Prayer. I can tell a lot of believers, followers of Christ, people who love the Lord, I can believe that they really don't believe in the power of prayer. And when I say power, I mean the power of prayer to change a person's life, the power of the Holy Spirit to reach a person. And I say this because if they truly believed in the power of the Holy Spirit, we would make less efforts in the flesh to change people. We would make less efforts in the flesh to correct people. We would make less fleshly efforts to instruct people. We would make less fleshly efforts to get our point across. You understand? You understand? Because if we truly believed in prayer, when we see, the Bible says, if you see a brother or sister overtaken in a fault or sin, let he who is spiritual restore such a one, what? In the spirit of meekness. So you have to even be meek before you can restore anyone. You have to be one who, first of all, considers yourself. We're not called to be another person's Holy Spirit, personal Holy Spirit. And I tell people that all the time. I used to get a lot of questions on various topics that people would send me and they want to ask me on it. And then the Holy Spirit just checked me, because I was wearing myself out. And then I was getting sort of irritated, these people don't read their Bibles, and that's not a good way to be. And I never want to put myself in a dangerous place where I am becoming someone's personal Holy Spirit. See, if we really believed in the power of prayer and the power of the Holy Spirit to reach people where they are, we would pray more for them. And that's why I think, for those of you, you don't have to believe in it, but I am a Christian who prays in tongues, in another language. You know why? Because it's a gift that God has given me. I'm not saying that He's given you that gift, okay? Now, there is a gift of praying in tongues. Those of you who may say, well, everybody should pray in tongues, I'm not going to even make this a message about tongues, okay? But there is the gift of tongues, and that's what I'm speaking of, and that is the gift of interpretation of tongues. But I'm speaking about the use of tongues for your heavenly prayer life. You know, the Bible says that we pray in the Holy Ghost, we pray in the Spirit, and even our understanding is not fruitful, but we're praying to who? We're praying unto God. And our spirit man is being built up as we do that. And I do that a lot because I don't want to pray based on what I see and what I think and what I have diagnosed with my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. If you are a person who truly loves and truly cares for someone, and if you see something that you perceive is an error in them, then your job is to pray and ask the Holy Spirit to make intercession for you and for them. According to what? The will of God, not according to your will, not according to your personal assessment. Even if you don't pray in an unknown tongue, pray the word of God that he may perfect those things that concern us. Amen? Pray the scriptures. You can't go wrong praying the word of God. Amen? And ask the Holy Spirit to lead you and guide you. Pray that we may become more like Christ, that we may become more like Him in every way, in our conversations, in our thoughts. Many of us struggle with thoughts. Many of us are entertaining wicked thoughts and evil whispers. If you haven't heard the message that I delivered on evil whisperers, I suggest that you go and listen to it. And accusers of the brethren. Many times, things can come off as they're really spiritual, and you think that you're hearing from God. But it's a spirit, but it's not a spirit of God. And we see that in the case of Job with his friends. And I believe it was Eliphaz that had that experience, that seemed so spiritual, and the stealth spirit passed by him. But the first thing it did, it accused Job. And we know that according to the word of God, Job was an upright man who feared the Lord. So we have to be mindful of the voices. There are many voices speaking in these last days. Now, I don't know how long this video is, you know, this audio is going. Many voices that are speaking, but we need to be prayerful and trust the power of the Holy Spirit to reach us and to reach our brothers and sisters where they are, okay? And let us not give ourselves to seducing spirits and lying spirits. Remember, not only does the Spirit speak, the Bible tells us in 1 Timothy chapter 4 that the Spirit speaks expressly. So not only does the Holy Spirit have a voice, Satan has a voice. We see this by him when he spoke to Jesus in the wilderness, you know, telling him, if thou be the Son of God. Amen. So he has a voice. He can speak and he says things to us. And he will even say things to us that sound spiritual. He will even say things and suggest things. One of a dear precious sister in Christ, I don't want to mention her video because I think, you know, I just don't want to mention her video right now because of the circumstances in which she made that video. But she pointed out something very, very significant in that video. She spoke about suggestive slander. You know, and we have to be very, very careful to hear voices that are suggesting things to us and slandering things and slandering our fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. We have to be very careful. Know that we fight against an adversary who is not a dummy. We like to call him that old dumb devil, but he's not dumb at all. Not at all. Excuse me, I'm taking you to West Africa now. But he's not dumb at all, okay? So, listen. Be wise as a serpent, but harmless as a dove. And know that every voice that's speaking is not necessarily the voice of God, even if it proclaims to be. Amen? And when we're listening and choosing people to listen to, be sensitive to the Holy Spirit, okay? Be sensitive to the Holy Spirit and let him lead you. All right. God loves you. I love you. And this message is for me, first partaker. And I pray that some of you will receive. Some of you will reject it. And some of you will become offended. Be very, very careful of offense. It's a major stumbling block. Major stumbling block. Amen. And my intention is not to offend anyone, but to preach the truth. And if I did not preach the truth, if I feared man more than God, I could not be a servant of God. Amen? So I want to be a servant, a slave for him. And whatever he tells me to do, I'm going to do it. All right? God loves you. Have a wonderful week. And take this lesson with you throughout the week, that we're going to practice hearing the voice of God. We're going to practice praying for one another. And we're going to practice becoming sensitive to the Holy Ghost and allowing him to work in the lives of others. Amen? Yielding our will and our desire over to him, all right? And if you don't know the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I ask you to repent. First of all, repent, confess, turn away from your sins and turn towards him. Believe on him, be baptized, and get a Bible. Follow him and ask the Holy Spirit to fill you, because you're going to need the Holy Spirit. Amen? To discern between all of these strange voices in the land, you're going to need the voice of the Holy Spirit speaking to you. And you can only learn the voice of the Holy Spirit from his word. Amen? There are many strange voices that are speaking these days. And you want to make sure that you're hearing his voice. Amen? Begin to follow him. Whatever he tells you to do, do it. Amen? God bless you. God loves you. Have a wonderful week.